presentation, we are going to talk about a case of a hermaphrodite. What is hermaphroditism? So when we're talking about hermaphroditism, we are talking about a condition whereby one is born with both the male and the female organs. This was a case that presented at our radiology department. This was a 14-year-old boy. So from the exterior, he was perfectly a boy. So he started to have a problem with urination. The urine was being blocked for 2 weeks prior to the ultrasound examination. So the referring clinician was actually querying UTI. He was actually querying a problem that could have been occurred in the kidneys or in the urinary bladder. So he came with a request of KUB plus prostate. On ultrasound scan, here are the shocking findings. So you can see, this is what we saw. You see, this is the urinary bladder, and just below the urinary bladder here, you can see this hypoechoic lesion with some internal echogenic particles, as you see here. This is the lesion. Unfortunately, from the beginning, we thought that maybe this could have been a prostatic abscess. So you will see what we saw as we continued to interrogate this type of a lesion. You appreciate what we are talking about. In reality, or in essence, at our radiology department, we hardly come across these type of conditions. Since I started working at our radiology department, I can testify this is the first time I saw this type of a condition. You can actually see this is the urinary bladder, and then we have got a separate collection which is here, and there is no communication between the urinary bladder and this collection to query or to suspect a diverticulum. So there is no communication between these two. So in brief, or in short, let me discuss more or say more about hermaphrodite. So there is a condition which is called a true hermaphrodite. What is a true hermaphrodite? A true hermaphrodite is also called an avotesticular disorder. So in this type of a disorder, you actually see both the testicular portion and the ovaries in the same individual. So let's go down here and see what was the observation. So you can actually have a feel of what we saw. So in longitudinal section, you can actually see the uterus here, and you can see the collection is protruding all the way and is going up here like this. So that's the collection that you are seeing. Then you can see here there's no opening, so there's a closed ending this side. Doing it again like here, you can actually appreciate that it's going all the way up here, and then it's coming here, and it's well outlined here. You can see there's a nice outline here of the collection. Again, you can actually appreciate the collection going all the way like this, and it's all well contained in a capsule like this. You can actually see the internal echoes or the septations, which are not complete, that you are seeing here. You can actually appreciate what you are seeing here. You can see this whole lot of collection which is well contained in here. So again, we thought this could be a rectum, but it was not. Was the rectum was there, and it was actually very distinct from the rectum. So you can appreciate that here the puzzle was actually growing as I was doing the scan. It was becoming more and more and more confusing what it could be. You see, this is our urinary bladder, and you can see actually this collection here very much well outlined, but there's no communication here with the exterior. On this scan, I tried to check if the lesion was actually prosthetic in origin, or was originating from the prostate. So you can actually appreciate here in this transverse section that this is our urinary bladder, and then what we have here was or is our prostate. So we do have got our prostate here, and you can actually appreciate here the urethra, and you can actually see a calcification, a small calcification that we have here. This is a prostatic utricular calculi, as you can appreciate. So the same patient, this is our prostate, and then you see the lesion is somewhere up here. So from this end, you can actually appreciate that the lesion was actually distinct from the prostate. So it was not a prostatic in nature or in origin. So you can appreciate the distinction there. Again, from this end, you can actually see here is our nice prostate, and you can see the lesion starting to protrude somewhere here, and this is our urinary bladder with containing clear and anechoic urine, urinary bladder, our prostate, and then the cystic lesion there. So again, from this end, you can actually appreciate it now. So from this end, you can see the extension here, and then this is a little bit of a stricture that you're seeing here, and the collection bulges again here. So from assessment of this, it was now from this end that I started to suspect that this case that we have is actually a collection here in the end of cervix, and then here somewhere there looks like where we have got our oars, and here a collection in the uterus. So I need you to appreciate it again. You can actually see the stricture here, and then this is a collection. So from this end now, I was convinced, or I was somewhat convinced, that this could be a uterus, and then it's containing blood here, and then there's also blood collection in the endocervix. So this is characteristic, or it is suspicious of a condition that we call hematometra couples. So as the boy was just 14 years old, I believe, and I thought that this is the time that most women, they start their menstrual cycle or their menstrual period. So this boy, actually, according to my suspicion, I believe that it was the point where he started to have the period. This is blood from the period, and then there's no communication to the exterior. You can see that it was now actually accumulating like this. So the collection is actually occupying the uterus and the endocervix to qualify it as hematometra couples. Collection of blood only in the uterine cavity is called hematometra. So you can actually see here is our urinary bladder. There's no communication between the two. So this is our collection. This is our collection. This is our collection. I hope you are concurring with what I'm saying. At the start of the video, if you look again, there's something protruding here that I saw, and this was consistent with an ovary. At the beginning, somewhere here, there is something that is coming that is consistent with a right ovary. So from the outset, the patient was actually a boy. They were only the male genitalia, and we couldn't relate to any female features or characteristics. But from the inset, you can actually appreciate what we saw, that the patient did actually both the male and the female genitalia. However, the female genitalia wasn't completely formed. As you're seeing here, there is this closed opening. There's no opening here, so it's closed this side. So this is what then I concluded to be a case of a hermaphrodite. So as I saw that there is structures which mimics or which are consistent with the ovaries, and also we have testicular tissue. So this I concluded it to be a case of the AVO testicular disorder, which is also called a true hermaphrodite. So I referred this patient to the gynecologist, And to that end, or to that effect, the boy was successfully operated, and it was confirmed that it was indeed a case of a true hermaphrodite. So this was a case of a true hermaphrodite. So you can as well appreciate from this end our collection here. So you can actually see these internal echoes. This is consistent with a bit of fibrin strands or collection here. So this, I believe, is blood collection that we have here, just like this, just like that. The collection, you can see it, and you can also appreciate it, how it looked like. I believe you have seen what we saw, and also you are now appreciating what I appreciated. So what is the structure that I'm saying was consistent or was looking like an ovary? You can see here, look at this structure. You can actually see this, it looks like an ovary with the ovarian stroma there, and then the cortex there. So this, to me, looked like an ovary. So I concluded that this boy had actually both the genitalia, male and female genitalia. However, the male parts were dominant, and then the female parts, they were just inside with a communication to the exterior world. I thank you all, I thank you one, I thank you everyone for watching our videos. I wish you are learning, and your inspiration, it also motivates us and it keeps us going. I hope you are appreciating the diversity and the robustness of our cases that we come across at our radiology department. Gweru Provincial Hospital is one of the rich resource area that we have in terms of ultrasound cases. So it is prudent that time and again we keep you posted, and then we also appreciate what we are getting at our department. Thank you again. Thank you all.